I think it's time to join the Fun Seekers Radio Network in Ludlow Point.
This is the Ludlow Porch Show on the Fun Seekers Radio Network, broadcasting from the Falcon Inn and Conference Center in Suwanee, Georgia. Ludlow Show brought to you in part by Jasper Jeep. No matter where you live, your Jeep dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. By Tubular Coffee, call them and join the Ludlow Coffee Club. By Burt's Pumpkin Farm, family fun in the mountains. And by Taylor Construction Company, call them and never paint again. The toll-free line's now open at 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. And now, here's Ludlow Porch.
Well, good morning, Fun Seekers. How y'all? Friday. Catch-up day, talking about whatever is on your mind with some of the most interesting people in the country as we go to Harrison, Tennessee, and talk to Bob on the radio. Good morning, Bob.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How are you, sir?
I'm doing fine. Listen, I heard that advertisement about the place up there with the lights at Amicola Falls.
Yeah.
So I decided to have a little different Christmas, and me and my wife are going to go up there next Saturday and spend the night at the inn there and tour and see those lights. I think it'll be real great.
I promise you, you're going to enjoy it.
Yeah.
I promise you.
I heard you talking about Grandma got run over by a reindeer. I want to tell you this story.
All right.
Several years back, I had two of the, of course, naturally the cutest little granddaughters in the world. They came over my house. They were about 5 and 6. And all of a sudden, I hear them singing this song, Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer, and it just blew my mind.
And they knew all the words.
Yeah.
That's funny.
And I don't know where they learned the song, but I put it on tape. And I've got that tape, and one of these days when they're grown, they'll have it, and they can have a ball with it.
Oh, what a treasure. What a treasure.
And I thought it was so cute. One morning, I'm listening to a local disc jockey, and he's got a two-hour talk show in the morning, and he was wanting to know songs to play, you know, Christmas songs.
Uh-huh.
So I called him. I said, how about Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer? And a guy got mad at me about it.
Got mad at you?
Yeah. Yeah. You could tell it in his voice. And I called him several times after that, and you could tell in his voice. And I said, well.
What made him mad?
I don't know. I don't know. He didn't think there was anything funny about it, or it was a good song. I don't know why he was offended. He certainly wasn't where I was at.
You know what? That goes to show what I've always said. Something a friend offends everybody.
Yeah. You know, give you a little homespun philosophy of mine and see what your take is on it. I think two of the greatest gifts that a person can have is a good sense of humor and a smile. Unfortunately, I've never had that smile. Now, my wife's got a smile that lights up the room when you walk in. Boy, if they could teach kids that in school.
You know, the good sense of humor will just help get you through some very bad times if you've got that. It will change your life for the better, no question about it.
Yeah, it sure has helped me through the years, but I've always felt that, and I guess this is something back growing up, you know, you had to be a macho man or something, and I didn't have that smile, and of course then I got my teeth knocked out for football, so, but I just...
Then you were afraid to smile.
Yeah, but you know, I'm sure you've been around, maybe you're one of those people that, boy, you talk about attracting people to you. You got that smile, you'd conquer the world.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. My man, you have a great day.
You too, lady.
I'll talk to you soon.
All right.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. Man, talking about going to Amicalola Falls and seeing the falls and going out there and seeing the Birch Farm and just having a big time. What a place this is to go. Listen, they got about 2.5 miles. Of just beautiful scenes, 35 lighted scenes, Christmas scenes, religious scenes, and you can take that trip in on a hayride, or you can do it in your own vehicle. 2 miles of Christmas beauty, and try that with a hayride, particularly for the little guys who may not have been on a hayride. And the younger, the better. Over 500,000 lights and 35 scenes with lots of animation. Going to see a great big green frog jump right over your car and listen to the little ones squeal. Burt's Farm in the beautiful North Georgia Mountains. They're right outside the main gate there at Amicalola Falls. You can't miss them, or you might want to give them a call, 1-800-600-BERT, 1-800-600-BERT, and ask them about their schedules and get some direction from them. These are good folks, and you're going to enjoy this evening, I promise.
When all is said and done, no one is going to stand up and say, you know, the wonderful thing about Steve was that he had a 295-horsepower V8 sedan with traction control and speed-sensitive steering. You're not going to be remembered for your comprehensive porcelain plate collection, your sheepskin seat covers, your 197 bowling average, your hydro-powered lawn tractor, or your cashmere overcoat. When it's all over, no one will think much about your graphite shaft sand wedge. Ultimately, no one will be revered for what they have, though all are admired for what they have given. To those who contribute time and money to the causes that are important to them, thank you for all you've given. Imagine what more could do. Call 1-800-55-GIVE-5. It's what in the world you can do.
A public service message brought to you by Independent Sector and the Ad Council.
LaGrange, Georgia, and Buddy on the radio. Hello, Buddy.
Good morning, Mr. Ford.
Good morning, sir. How you doing?
First time caller.
Welcome. Good to have you.
Listen all the time, and it was like I was telling Denny, I've been kind of in and out of the truck and heard y'all talking about somebody needing the words to the wedding march.
Right. Uh-huh.
Well, I've got them.
Uh-huh.
I stopped at a payphone and after 17 years of marriage and 4 kids, my memory's kind of shot, so I can't recite them. But I do have them. My wife and I have sung them at many weddings. And
what if I could get you to fax those to me?
Well, I could.
I don't mean today because I know you're busy, but I'm.
Yeah, I can fax them to you, mail them to you, or whatever. But like I said, I've got that. We usually do that as a processional.
Uh huh.
Sometimes we've done it as a recessional. You know, when people are walking out.
Right.
Got all sorts of different wedding music. It's a pretty song, though. There's been many different arrangements of it. And to be perfectly honest with you, I don't know which arrangement I've got, but I've probably got two or three of them.
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, I'm not. But the words don't change with the arrangement, do they? The words are what we're interested in.
Yeah, the words probably don't. I imagine there have been some words rewritten to it. But anyway, it's. Let's see, it's. My mind's drawn a blank right now.
I understand.
Faithful and true, we lead you forth where love triumphant, shall crown you with joy. Star of renown, flower of the earth, blessed be you both, far from all life's annoy. Something like that.
Listen, when you get your hands on, give us a call back and we'll give you the fax number.
Okay.
Because I know you can't write it down there because you're in your car.
Uh-huh.
But do that for us.
Well, I've got a pen handy. If you can.
Have you really? Okay. It's a fax number 770.
Okay.
271-8023.
770-271-8023.
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, I'll fax you a copy of that and try and get it done as quick as I can.
I appreciate it. You drive carefully out there.
Okay.
Talk to you, buddy.
Bye-bye.
Nice man. We'll have that for you. Jasper Jeep Gang, no matter where you live, your Jeep dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. Let's go to Griffin, Georgia, and talk to Elfrida on the radio. Hello, Elfrida.
Hello, Redlo.
How you doing?
Fine.
Good.
I want to thank that Chichi man for that poem this morning.
A moving tribute.
Wasn't it nice?
Yes.
It's the man who wanted the tobacco road for his mother should not have got a copy yesterday. I've got a copy.
Okay.
And If he wants it, he can write the choo-choo man in Dallas, and then he will put me in touch with him.
All right.
And the same goes for Big Mac. If Big Mac would get in touch with choo-choo, I think I have something that he might be interested in.
All right.
And that's about it for the day.
Okay, Elfrida, glad you called.
Hope you have a nice weekend.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Rome, Georgia, and Pete Moss. Hello, Pete.
Hey, dude. How you doing?
I'm good today.
I hope that fellow that called you, dude, is still listening.
Somehow I expect he's on a rock and roll station. What do you think?
I imagine so.
What do you think? Yeah.
First of all, I want to thank the cleaning lady. I got my car yesterday.
Oh. She's a busy lady, isn't she?
Yes, she is. And the wedding march. Since I'm an expert on marriage, I've been married a whole bunch of times.
All right.
I know the second line. Here comes the bride, all dressed in white.
Okay.
That's all I know.
All right, well, we'll fill in the blanks.
Okay. And over the last couple of weeks, you've been talking about George of the Jungle, the movie.
Yeah.
I got to thinking about who would we cast as the leading character as George. My first thought was John Goodman. But then it struck me this morning, now, Danny DeVito.
That's great. That's great casting. I don't know who's playing it, because this thing's in production right now, but Danny DeVito would have been great.
He would, wouldn't he? But that's all I got.
You take care of yourself.
Okay, be good.
Talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255, Lowndes County, Georgia, and Aubrey. Hi, Aubrey.
Good morning, Ludlow.
Morning, pal.
I couldn't let the weekend come without saying hello.
Well, thank you.
What you doing this weekend?
Going to be kind of quiet, I hope. I got a couple of things in the mill, but I'm going to try to lay back and take it easy.
I wanted to talk with you a little bit about the record Grandma Got Ran Over by a Reindeer.
All right.
Well, not mainly about that, but you were talking about the 45 RPM record, which I've got a pretty good collection of.
Uh-huh.
And I thought they were also where you couldn't get them anymore, but, you know, I was at my father's house a month or so ago. And he's got a home computer, like a lot of folks do nowadays. I don't know how he come up with this program, but on the home computer, they have a list of all the 45 RPM records you can get. You can order them through the mail. I don't know how you come up with that program, but I'd have to ask him. But you can still get 45 RPM records, which I was thinking about getting.
I guess you better have something to play them on, too, hadn't you, when you get them?
Yeah, well, I do.
Good.
Anyway, I wanted to, I'm going to call my local news talk radio station at noon. I'm going to talk to them about trying to put your show on the air.
Okay, good.
I was going to kind of go to bed for y'all, if you don't mind.
That's the reason we love y'all, but we don't mind at all. Thank you, buddy.
All right, and I'll talk with you later. You have a good weekend.
Thank you, now. Take care.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. Back to the basement of the Tubular Coffee Company. How you doing, John?
I'm doing fine, Ludlow. Just doing fine. We are roasting coffee left and right, round the clock, trying to get the freshest coffee out to all the Ludlow listeners in the land. I tell you, we've been talking about stocking stuff, and as I got to thinking, I said, another really good stocking stuffer is the Ludlow coffee mug in that other gift pack that we've got.
Boy, yeah.
I mean, that would make a great one right there. I mean, they could get up every morning, have fresh coffee, and get to look at you every morning.
And that'll help them get the coffee down.
There you go.
They'll need the coffee.
That's exactly right.
What y'all got, 8 or 10 gift packs down there?
We got 8 or 10 gift packs. We've got something for everyone's budget. I mean, they can be. You can give coffee till summertime or next fall, and people can still enjoy fresh coffee. So, I mean, it's a one call. All you got to do is call us at 1-800-488-2852, and we can take care of all your Christmas ideas and your gifts.
It's a great idea for people with a long client list or a sales list and who want to remember all these folks, but just don't have time to deliver all of this person.
That's exactly right. We can do all the work for them. They call us, send us their list, and we can get all the packages out anywhere in the country.
Give us the number.
1-800-488-2852. That's 800-488-2852, and we can take your order.
We appreciate it, buddy. I'll talk to you later.
Thank you, Ludlow. We'll see you.
Hang in there, John.
Uh-huh. Bye-bye.
More right after this.
George of the Jungle, strong as he can be. Watch out for that tree. George of the Jungle, lives a life that's free. Watch out
with the help of a friend.
Watch out for that tree. Dumb as a rock, as Phil just said. Indeed, 1-800-572-8255, Albany, Georgia. Big Mac on the air.
Good morning, Ludlow.
Hi, big boy. How you doing?
Didn't he tell you where I was?
No.
I'm in my car on the car phone in a parking lot outside the Peachtree Mall in Columbus.
All right.
We're picking you up on the LaGrange station.
Good, good.
Going doing some final Christmas shopping, so I'm doing mine from the car.
Yep. Smart man, you got a good book to read?
That's what I'm calling for.
All right.
I have misplaced your box number somewhere and your zip code number.
Well, let me see if I just can't. I just may happen to have that.
All right.
Have you also got a pencil in your car?
I got pen in hand and ready to write.
Post office box 1804.
1804.
Fayetteville, Georgia 30214.
30214. Fayetteville?
Yeah.
Okay, and is that addressed to Fun Seekers Network or to you?
Just to me.
Okay. All right. I will put you a check in the mail when I get back tomorrow.
And I'll put you some books in the mail. Be sure and put a note in there how you want these signed.
Yeah, okay. And Danny and Bozo, if he happens to drift through there, that'd be great to get them to write something there for me, too.
Okay.
I would
appreciate it. You going to let Bozo write something, anything he wants to?
Oh, anything he wants to, yeah.
You are one brave guy.
Well, she said, you know, it's clean underwear or get you some books. And I figured this is the best thing to have in an accident.
That's right. Your mother would be so proud.
I've got that album of Elmo and Patsy. They did stick it in the song in the Christmas album.
Yeah.
And but she won't let me bring it along and play it when we ride on a trip.
Drives her nuts.
Yeah. There's a great song on there in addition to that one called Percy the Puny Poinsettia. If you can ever get a copy of it and listen to that.
You know, everybody in the music business wants to get that big Christmas song because that's forever.
Mm-hmm.
That keeps the bucks coming in until Social Security is gone.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, everybody wants to hit that one.
Well, I don't know whether that's the great one or not, but we've had fun listening to it over the years. It used to be the staple at the Waffle House. I mean, everybody going to the Waffle House would play that. And the waitresses would go crazy because they heard it all day long.
I bet they did.
They used to tell me, but that, and it was Elmo and Patsy's version. I'm tickled to death to find out that the Howard Schrovers did it. I did not know that.
Yeah, great version, I think.
It sure is.
Yeah.
Well, better get inside and catch up with her. But
you ain't ever going to catch up with her, but try.
I know it. Y'all have a great weekend.
I'll talk to you, buddy.
Talk to you later.
1-800-572-8255, Mineral Bluff, and my friend Joyce. Hi, Joyce.
Hello, how are you?
I'm great. How you doing?
Pretty good. Loving this weather. We're going to finally get up here. It's been raining for a couple of days.
Well, I say sunshine's on the way.
It is. And I'm right here in the Mineral Valley in a valley I bought.
Oh, good.
And moved my son up here out of the traffic down around Marietta and Woodstock.
All right.
But I was telling him that 15 years ago today was a Sunday. And I was 45 years old, and I had my fifth son. And there was 20 years difference between the last two. It's been a trip.
You've been a mama all your life, haven't you?
I've been a mother ever since I was started babysitting when I was about 10. But we love it up here. Everything's changed with him up here out of city life. And but he thinks today, Friday the 13th, is the most horrible thing. He just said all kinds of things are going to happen to him today.
Uh-huh.
But I said, but you were born on Sunday. He's always been there talking about bad luck this morning on the gospel show on the, you know, appeal station.
Yeah.
And the bad people believe in bad luck.
Uh-huh.
That's not true. He's been healthy, happy, weighs 200 pounds.
He sounds healthy.
He's never been sick a day in his life.
All right. God love
him. As old as I was, you know, when I had him and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So he's just been a joy. Of course, it's been a trip. It's been a trip chasing a kid at my age.
I guarantee you, and not only that, well, you had said you had five sons?
I had four by a previous marriage, and then 20 years later, I had Joshua.
Oh, that's fun. That's great. You take care of yourself, and glad you called.
One more thing?
Sure.
I drank about 10 cups of coffee every morning. I've always meant to ask you. I wish y'all would send me a sample of your coffee.
There are no samples left. They were sending samples out for a month or so, but I think they sent them all.
Okay, if they'll send me an address, something, I'll order some.
Well, do it by telephone, 1-800.
Okay.
488-2852.
Okay, everybody's talking about it. It tastes real good.
You're going to love it.
Anyway, you have good holidays.
I'm glad you called, my friend.
Okay, bye-bye.
Take care. 1-800-572-8255. And it's still overcast here at the Falcons training camp at Swanee, but it looks like the sunshine might be trying to break. It looks like it's lightening up a little bit outside. We're supposed to have a pretty nice day after all of our rain and the thunderstorms last night came through right after our parade. And the parade went well. The thunderstorm went well. It was a great day in Madison, Georgia. We'll be right back. You stay with us.
So she can raise her kids in a decent neighborhood.
Left side of the road, isn't it? I'm Bibby Borio, Senior Finance Officer for Jaguar Cars, here in Coventry, England. This beautiful car we're riding in came with the job. I'm also the first woman ever on Jaguar's board of directors. You know, the auto industry is pretty male-dominated, but performance on the job is what's recognized, at least at my company. If you're good, you get noticed. The same was true for me in school. Was I afraid to be smart in front of boys in class? No way. My parents and my teachers never expected less from me because I was a girl. Do you have a daughter? Tell her it's cool to be smart in front of boys, especially if they're in the boardroom. Expect the best from a girl. That's just what you'll get.
Help your daughter stand up and be heard in school. Call 1-800-WCC4GIRLS. This message brought to you by the Ad Council and the Women's College Coalition.
Again. Dynamite, are you there?
I'm here, and that was my fault.
How long you been calling this show?
You won't the phone, and I ran to my dryer, and I didn't think you'd come back on that quick. So I was holding on. I had the other phone laying on had the receiver laying on my desk, and I went to pick up to turn the portable phone off, and turned it on. When I did, I hit the button to disconnect the telephone, and I thought, I don't believe I did that.
I knew you'd call back.
And here it is, Friday the 13th. So I've done mine for the day.
Yeah.
Wanted to tell you that I also got a card from the cleaning lady. Apparently, everybody got one.
I think so. A large group.
Yep, I think so. Well, I'm going to treat Charlie to lunch for his birthday at the Blue Willow.
Oh, good.
And I've already got reservations.
Oh, that's wonderful.
So hopefully everything will work out with that.
When's his birthday?
The 23rd.
He was almost a Christmas baby.
Almost.
Yeah.
His uncle said that was the coldest night in the world, the night he was born. I wanted to tell you some of the old tapes I went through the other night. Some of them were from your shows from way back.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them was just, I got the biggest kick out of it. It's where Radiator was announcing about the twins.
Oh, yeah.
I was trying to remember the date on that. Was that around 88, 89?
Yeah, just about.
Something like that. I wanted to put the date on that tape to label it so I wouldn't tape over it.
Just about, yeah.
Yeah, and have you heard about our crazy weather that we're expecting in the next few months?
I heard it's going to be kind of a roller coaster.
Yeah.
Warm and cool and warm and cool.
But the one thing I don't want an early spring. I like spring okay, but I want to have some winter time.
Yeah, me too. I expect we're going to.
Well, according to Kurt, we will. And one of the things I thought was when we were talking about old Blue Eyes,
mm-hmm.
You remember the show where I won the real certificate and I blew it? I couldn't remember what old Blue Eyes' name was. I tell you, I think I got half a brain, but then I'm a wacko. That's what makes me
that's
wacko.
That's exactly right. I wonder if that was on Friday the 13th.
No, I don't think so. But I still have that, and it's very special to me. And like I said, what makes it valuable is that Denny addressed the envelope.
Oh, that does.
It greatly
enhances the value there.
That's right. I mean, I've got the date on it and everything. And I mean, you know, he can't deny it because it's his handwriting.
Frame the whole thing.
That's right. I'm going to do that. But anyway, well, I'm sorry that I blew it. But
well, that's all right.
Friday the 13th.
That's all right. I knew you kicked the plug out of something. I wasn't sure what it was.
Yeah, well, you pulled one on me too. So anyway, but I'm used to that. So, but anyhow, I was trying to think of anything else. That sometimes when I'm prepared to talk, you don't have time. And then when I don't have anything written down, you know, I mean, you catch me either way. I can't win.
You can't win. Well, always be prepared. Don't forget what the Boy Scouts said.
Yeah, well, I guess you're right about that.
Be prepared.
That's right.
You take care of your sweet self.
Well, you too.
Wait a minute.
Uh-oh.
Denny's got a correction here.
Uh-oh.
He said he doesn't want to rain on your parade, but... Big Louise addressed that. It's her handwriting.
You know, all this time I've been thinking that I had something really valuable that Denny had done that.
Yeah, but how many folks have anything from Big Louise?
Well, this is true, too. You know, I do have something valuable. I mean, there's just no question about it.
A collector's item.
That's right. I mean, who knows what I might get for it one day.
Yeah, who knows? You take care.
Okay, you have a good week.
I'll talk to you, my friend.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. You know, I had forgotten until we got on the air that today was Friday the 13th. And I wonder if anybody out there taking any special precautions. Because, well, I think if we've established one thing on this show over the years, is that people are superstitious. Do you take any special precautions on Friday the 13th, or do you... do what I did and let it slip up on you. Friday the 13th. A lot of folks worry about that one. First Pumpkin Farm Gang. Good, clean family fun in the Georgia mountains. Don't forget the light show. Call 1-800-600-BURT. Ludlow and Denny, as we go to Traveler's Rest and talk to Gus on the radio. Hello, Gus.
Hey, Bud. How you doing?
I'm doing good. You all right?
Oh, yeah. Doing fine this beautiful day after them thunder bumpers last night.
It was a good one.
Had a lot of rain, Bud.
Yeah, we did too.
Listen, I know you don't do this much on your show. I don't know whether you ever do it on your show. But you got a lot of listeners down in Griffin, Georgia. And I got a special request for them people that live down there.
All right.
I got an aunt and uncle that's going to celebrate their 70th wedding anniversary.
Wow.
And, you know, that's a milestone.
It really is.
And they both of them are in pretty good health. They live out at College Manor. They had to move into an assisted living program last year. And both of them in their 90s now. But if any of your listeners down there know Mr. and Mrs. C.L. Sanders... and they've been living in Griffin all their life, so... but like she said here a while back, she's outlived a lot of those people she knew.
Well, but I bet you everybody in Spalding County knows Mr. and Ms. Sanders out
there. They should, because they have been there forever.
That's very interesting.
What, 70th anniversary, that is something. That'll be the 23rd.
I bet they're going to... have some kind of celebration at that place.
Yeah, no doubt they will.
That's wonderful.
I'll tell you what, but since you know so many people down there, so many people down there know you and listen to this program, I thought maybe some of them might want to drop them a card.
I bet they did. Give us the name of the place where they are now.
College Manor, M-A-N-O-R. That's in Old College Street there in Griffin.
Okay, all right, good enough.
Yeah, they just moved in about a year ago, and after they got kind of ancient, as she said, both of them in their 90s now.
Well, we wish them happy days.
Well, I appreciate you letting me put that on the air.
Oh, glad to do it. And they'll get a bunch of cards, I bet you.
Well, I hope so. Ludlow, I appreciate it, and you have a good weekend. I'm sure glad your parade didn't get rained on too much.
Oh, it wasn't bad at all. We got a little wet, but that was all right. It was fun. We had an umbrella, but you know when you're riding an open wagon, you're going to get a little wet.
Well, at 4:30 here yesterday afternoon, the bottom fell out. I thought, oh, God, Ludlow. Gonna get it.
Gus, I'll talk to you, buddy.
Okay, bud.
Take care now.
Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. Christmas parade. Great success. A lot of fun. A lot of fun. Even in the rain. We'll be right back. Why in the world do so many people go to Jasper, Georgia to buy their new cars? Well, because that's where Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth is. They're the largest, busiest, best Jeep dealership in the world. How did it get to be the biggest Jeep dealership in the world? Price. That's right. You see, these good folks figured out early on that Price sells cars. One price shopping. No haggling, no tricks, no buffalo feathers ever. Hundreds and hundreds of cars in stock and the nicest people you'll ever deal with, I promise. You hang on to this gang, Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth, and Jasper, Georgia. Now, they're open Monday through Saturday, 8 to 7, but never, ever on Sunday. Remember one thing, no matter where you live, your automobile dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. No matter where you live, your automobile dealership is in Jasper, Georgia. You go in there for your next new car.
Before a child is 6 years old,
activities for nothing. I mean, sworn in Clinton's already sworn in. So why do we just spend that money for that, that day, you know, that ceremony and stuff when all it takes is the $5 cab ride, Chief Justice will be swearing back in, so.
Yeah, you mean that, you actually mean that cost $15 million?
Yeah, it's on the news the other night.
I'll be darned. I had no idea.
Yeah.
But they got to swear him in because his business license is expiring.
Yeah, why don't you just get the Chief Justice to take a $5 cab ride over to the White House, swear him in, that's it.
Well, then you wouldn't get to see it. And we know how you're looking forward to that.
Oh, yeah. That's no work. And another little thing I found out as well, and on the Fox News channel last night.
Uh-huh.
Our beloved ex-congressman and everything will get themselves a cost of living adjustment to the tune of $50 million the expense of the taxpayers. Oh. All those retired right now, you know?
Yeah, they have got it made.
Tell me about it.
Got it made.
And they want to cut what, Social Security stuff? Give me a break, Lalo. Give us a break.
Who have you heard talk about cutting Social Security?
Well, this is on TV on the Fox News channel. They had a couple of congressmen on there and everything.
Yeah, that's political suicide. Nobody's going to do that.
But the thing of it is, the arrogance of themselves to get themselves the cost of living adjustment, these former congressmen, you know?
Yeah.
Well, at the same time, they want to cut the benefits of the poor and the elderly.
Arrogance is the word, my man. You got that one absolutely right. I got to get out of here. You take care. Talk to you soon. 1-800-572-8255. Ludlow and Denny, the Fun Seekers Radio Network. Catch up day. Give us a call.
June with AM 1250, your down-home connection, WITH Madison, Greensboro, Edenton.
NBC Radio.
Or you might want to call and let them give you the zip code. Our number 1-800-572-8255. This had to happen, gang. All these Christmas specials, people are taping these and keeping them and playing them year-round. And David Letterman's top 10. These are kind of funny. These are the holiday specials on television that didn't make it. These are rejected holiday specials from David Letterman. Number 10, Gallagher smashes melons in Bethlehem. Number 9, my favorite, A Creepy, Creepy Christmas with Michael Jackson. Number 8 from Fox Television, called When Reindeer Attack. Number 7 is A Country Holiday with Martha Stewart and a bunch of actors pretending to be her family. Let's see another. Oh, Christmas at Rikers Island. It's a wonderful 10 years to life. Number 2, The President Who Ate Christmas. Got a bunch of those. Kind of fun stuff. 1-800-572-8255. We are having a roller coaster of weather now. They've been talking about it getting warm and getting up about the 60s, but during the news break a few minutes ago, we walked outside, and it is still cold. But the sun has started to peep out, so maybe, just maybe, maybe we're going to have a pleasant afternoon for you to get out and about and do some of your Christmas shopping. Our number 1-800-572-8255. And a quick reminder, on Monday, our resident folkologist, Dick Freimeyer, will be in here ready to kick things off and make sure that you know, number one, how to keep your Christmas tree fresher. He'll give you that recipe. Number one, he'll got a fire retardant thing, which is probably a pretty good idea. And bear in mind, I don't know if any of these work, but it's worth a try, plus his energy drink that we just get rave reviews over. And we'll be talking about recipes and the fun stuff with Freimeyer. You know how that goes, and Christmas traditions and home remedies, as always, will kind of lead the way. Then on Thursday, Dr. J.T. Tom Cooper is going to be our special guest, famed diet doctor. And Dr. Cooper will be telling us how to get through the holidays without putting some extra padding on our person. So, got a good week lined up for you as we head into Christmas and start our eating orgy that will start different times for different families, but it's going to go right through New Year's with the parties and the get-togethers and the great desserts. Kind of makes you look forward to eating, doesn't it? Yes. 1-800-572-8255. We're going to get right back to the phones after we take care of these very special people.
He's been called the Mark Twain of our time, and the Fun Seekers Network is pleased to offer some of his funniest bits. The Best of Louis Grizzard is now available by mail order. Send your check or money order for $12 for the cassette or $16 for the compact disc and get ready to laugh with The Best of Louis Grizzard.
Nick, it means you ain't got no clothes on and you up to something.
Send your check or money order to the Fun Seekers Network, 2 Falcon Place, Suwanee, Georgia, 30174. $12 cassette, $16 for CD. To Fun Seekers Network, 2 Falcon Place, Suwanee, Georgia.
Living in a world like this one is hard to feel. You can't change it, but we must try.
Hi, I'm Malik Yoba. I play a cop on TV. I wrote this song because I need to see things change. Too many kids are dying in our streets from violence. I know because I was shot when I was 15. I survived, but each day there are 10 kids that don't. And we can do something if we just try. Be brave enough to walk away from violence and those that push it. Make a pledge to yourself to turn away from guns as a solution to solve your conflict. You can find smart, peaceful ways to settle arguments. I survived getting shot, but not everyone does. Don't let it happen to you.
All you have to do is try.
A message from the U.S. Department of Justice, the Crime Prevention Coalition, and the Ad Council.
We wish you a chili burger and a mug of cold beer.
Load the grill with fatty meat. Put it on a bun and eat. French fries, the brown skin vegetables.
Is that on an album, Denny? We'll give out that album number in a little while. 1-800-572-8255. Bozo Roberts on the radio. Hello, Bozo.
Hello, that was recorded at my last cover party.
It was it?
That was me and Denny out by the table at the food table.
I love that.
We laid back, singing and eating.
That's kind of what
Somebody had a microphone on.
What we do during the holidays, yeah. Mr. Microphone.
Just had laid back with the, having a roly-poly Christmas.
What's on your mind today, Bozo?
Oh, I don't know. Just kind of hanging back. What are we going to do this Christmas, Ludlow?
Well, I don't know. We got to get through this Friday the 13th first. You mean, what are we going to do on the air?
Yeah.
You want to come on and play Santa Claus for us? That'd be fun.
If I could do that, I could change my voice. I'd go... Oh, boy, won't let come a little boy.
I'd never guess that was you.
Huh? No. And I could say things like the store kind of Santa Claus saying, like, well, we'll see what we can do.
You know what always amazes me to walk by the line? Number one, I enjoy seeing the children line up to see Santa Claus who are really anxious. But there's always at least two or three who are scared to death, don't want to do that, and they're being made to go have a good time.
Mama going to throw that baby in that man's lap. It's like handing him over to a piranha.
Well, whether he likes it or not.
It was a couple of days ago. We went and do some more shopping. And I had to drive my wife out to do some shopping while I took the girls across the street.
Uh-huh.
We went into this store, and they had a Santa Claus there at the store who was seeing kids. And my girls had already seen him one time. And they want to see him again because they like to get those candy canes.
Yeah.
And so they walked over and sat in their lap. And Santa Claus was all jolly and laughing. And he said, and what would you like for Christmas this year? To my older daughter. She said, I already told you once. That's a true story.
And now she's worried that he's going to forget.
Well, I told her, I said, sometimes, I said, Santa's cheese slips off his cracker. And he don't understand. I said, but I promise you, he'll get your list.
Yeah, oh yeah, write the letter. That's funny.
She looked him right in the eyes. I told you once. Stupid old man. She didn't say that. That's what she was thinking.
Yeah, that's exactly what she was thinking. And she was thinking, if he's forgotten this one, he's going to forget them all.
She said also, after she went to see him the first time, she said, he didn't remember us. From the year before.
Funny. Out of the mouths of babes.
I bet you that the Star Santas could write a book, too.
Oh, don't you know it? Don't you know? I read the other day, somebody sent me a fax with some statistics on it. The average Santa Claus in a mall sees 12,000 children.
That's an hour, I believe.
That is, yeah. And I wonder how many pictures they sell.
Probably half those.
Did you pay for the pictures, Bozo?
The first time.
Yeah.
The older one, the second time, she said, how come nobody took our pictures? We already got the pictures.
Bozo, you take care of yourself, big boy.
I'll see you later.
I'll talk to you. Badger Jet Airlines gang with low fares every day, everywhere they fly. Let's get right back to the phones. Go to Walton County, Georgia, and talk to my buddy, John Boy.
Good morning, King Lud.
Good morning, bud. How you doing?
I'm doing great. I'm kind of embarrassed that I told you I'd try to come by to see you yesterday, and we didn't make it.
Well, that's all right.
Well, we got in the monsoon. We were north of here.
Oh, bad rain.
And it came down, and I said, boy, it's headed that away. And, well, we were delivering things for folks that couldn't get out and about.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah, they did a very smart thing at that parade. It was just really threatening, although it was not raining, and they started about 15 minutes early.
Oh, yeah.
And
that's good.
And it was sprinkling, but nobody, it didn't seem to bother anybody. People out with raincoats and umbrellas, and everything just kept wandering. It wasn't a hard rain until after the parade, and then it come a gully washer.
It come a sense of humor rain.
Boy, it did.
Speaking of sense of humor, you were talking a little while ago about sense of humor. Our preacher used to say, now, I know the Lord had a sense of humor, because when I stand up here and look out there at you folks.
Not only, if you don't believe the Lord has a sense of humor, look at a camel carefully sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
Funny animal.
They'll say the guy called in this morning, and I'm not trying to preach this morning, don't get me wrong, but as they say, 'tis the season.
Yeah.
But the guy said that he went to a church, or there was a wedding in a church. I think he said there was a wedding in a church, and it was the type of church that didn't have any musical instruments.
Uh-huh.
Don't you feel sorry for those folks?
They're very happy with it. I've got a lot of relatives in that church, and they're very happy with it.
Is that right?
And we'll tell you in a minute. Yeah.
Well, I wonder now, this is like a joyful noise to the Lord. You know, because I'm a drummer in church,
mm-hmm.
but I just can't imagine sitting in church without any instruments, especially when the Bible tells you to have them in church.
Well, no, the Bible says make a joyful noise. It doesn't say play the spoons or the trumpet. It just says make a joyful noise.
Well, now, Psalms 150 does say that.
What does it say?
It says make a joyful noise unto the Lord with the sounding, the high-sounding sound of the cymbals and the sound of the trumpet and the psaltery of the harp.
All right. I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Psalms 150. But anyhow,
you're going to start arguments all over the country right this minute.
Well, I'm only going by what the Bible says.
Okay.
One thing real quick. Do you remember the movie Holiday Inn?
Yeah, very well.
Now, is that where White Christmas was first?
Yeah, that was the movie that introduced it.
Well, they didn't do a whole lot of it. You know it?
Did the whole song.
Well, yeah, but Bing sang part of it, and then Marjorie Reynolds sang part
right,
of it.
Yeah.
And you would expect a big deal. I think the movie White Christmas had more of the song White Christmas than Holiday Inn.
I think that's one of those things when they thought they just had a nice little Christmas song.
Oh, yeah.
I don't believe they knew what kind of impact White Christmas was going to have.
Well, it was a good movie.
Yeah, they had enough sense to name the next one White Christmas to take advantage of.
I got out some of my old movies last night. One of them was, I have a tape just nothing with old Christmas specials.
Uh-huh.
And Jackie Gleason, where he bought his wife a Christmas present.
Yeah.
You remember that?
No, don't remember that.
He bought a Christmas present. Anyhow, he had to wind up hawking his...
Ralph Cramden.
Ralph Cramden.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, he had to wind up hawking his bowling ball to get her a nice Christmas present, and then she'd give him a bowling ball bag for Christmas. Oh, me. Buddy, have a good weekend.
Okay, buddy, you do the same. I'll talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, pal. JCH Entertainment Gang are the folks who bought...
...listen to Ludlow, because it sure beats watching silly cartoons and listening to rock and roll. I say listening to rock and roll. But the main reason we listen to Ludlow here on the farm is that it keeps us all away from doing chores, son. I mean, I'd rather listen to Ludlow Porter than slop a hog any day. Besides, Ludlow's smarter than the average bear, son. So be sure to listen to the Ludlow Port Show weekdays, and you can put your chores off till the weekend, son.
Watch your P's and Q's. Hang up your clothes and clean up your room. Do everything that you're supposed to do.
Cause Santa Claus is watching you.
Dancing, prancing, bitching, coming, cubing, dining, listening, Bruce and Marvin.
Say, well, Rudolph.
Say, well, say he dislocated his hip in a twist contest, and he's all sober up in the hospital. Yeah, but we've got a swinging replacement. Say, we got the fastest seed from the sands of the rainy desert. Say, we got Clyde the camel. And then he says, oh, Clyde, oh, you big camel. And Clyde says, just camel for me, man. Say, I'm pulling this leg fast I can. Now you steering better be good. And act like all the steering should. Be careful of what you say and do.
Cause Santa Claus is watching you.
And oranges, 170 ponies, 3,000 sets of drums, 7,000 comic books, and a do-it-yourself guitar course, complete with an 8x10 colorful toy, bold guitar, suitable for framing, yeah, and you can hear him explain as he drove out of sight, on dashing, dancing, passing, vixen, common, cubing, diamond, blissing, and Bruce, and Marvin, oh, Clyde, and Clyde says, put your camera for Merry Christmas, everybody.
Ray Stevens, Christmas time, Santa Claus is watching you. I got a quote for you. Denny, see if you know this one. Due to the shape of the North American elk's esophagus, even if it could speak, it could not pronounce the word lasagna. I think you could figure that out if you thought about that. Due to the shape of the North American elk's esophagus, even if it could speak, it could not pronounce the word lasagna. That's Cliff Clavin from Cheers. The last word in a tribute play. That's from a book called Mom Always Said Don't Play Ball in the House and other stuff we learned from TV. I think that's the best one in the book, but there's another one. Let's see if I can find it. I saw a minute ago. Oh, yes. Here's one from the Partridge family. This is from Danny Partridge, a quote. Danny Partridge says, I've been a kid, and I've been an adult, and believe me, adultery isn't what it's cracked up to be. 1-800-572-8255 is our number, and we have it. We have performed an impossible task. If you were listening the first hour, a gentleman called and wanted the words to the wedding march. And he said he had heard it in German and tried to have it had it translated, but he couldn't. I have a fax in my hand that purports to be the words to the wedding march. And just let me give them to you, because this is nothing you're ever going to tap your foot to, but let me give you the words. The facts didn't come out as well as I'd like for it to, but for the couple of words that I might not be able to translate, but here, generally speaking, is what those words say. And you know what I'm talking about, the wedding march. Da, 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 here comes the bride. Faithful and true, we lead ye forth, where love triumphant shall crown ye with joy. Star of renown, flower of the earth, blessed be ye both from all life's annoy. Champion, victorious, go thou before, made bright and glorious, glorious, go there before. Mirth's noisy reaver, ye have forsaken. Tender delights for you now awaken. Fragrant abode, enshrine ye with bliss. Splendor and joy, enjoy ye dismiss. And there they are. And I don't know why he wanted them, but now he has them. And if he'll call back, we'll send him a copy of that, the wedding march. Only one of the many services from our research department here, and you experts out there in Radio Land. Our number 1-800-572-8255. It is Friday. It is that day of the week that we kind of kick everything open and give you an opportunity to get caught up on what's been going on the air, what's been going on in your life, and what's been going on here right at Christmas time. So we will talk to you about all of that. Also want to remind you, got a big lineup next week. Going to have a good time. Frymeyer on Monday will be here with all his home remedies, and that is always fun. And he'll have his lemon juice for his fingers, and so funny, he'll come in here every time, been doing it for years with a lemon, and before he goes on the air to make sure his memory's in top working order, he rubs lemon juice on his fingers and swears that helps his memory. It does for me. 1-800-572-8255, right back after this. I want to talk to you about my friends at Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth in Jasper, Georgia. These are the folks who work hard every day to make sure doing business with them is a good experience. Here's some of the ways they do it. No dickering. Their salespeople are all on salary. They're there to make sure your needs are met and your questions are answered. A huge selection of Jeeps, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth, and those much-in-demand minivans and trucks. Let me tell you how their no dickering policy works. When new cars are delivered to Jasper Jeep, they put their low price on that new car. And that's the price. No add-ons, no inflated interest rates, no tricks ever. Just good folks doing a job and doing it better than anybody else. Jasper Jeep, Dodge, Chrysler, Plymouth in Jasper, Georgia. They're open 8 to 7 Monday through Saturday, but never, ever on Sunday. No matter where you live, gang, your Jeep dealership is in beautiful Jasper, Georgia.
A father working two jobs to support his family, yet still making time for some one-on-one basketball with his son, a teenager with ideas of his own,
The father encourages the son not to make the mistake he once made. The same mistake the son's friends, recent dropouts, are now making. Trading in their last years of school for what seems like a big paycheck now. The friends pressure the son to join them. He hears it from both sides. Whose side are you on? We're the Coalition for America's Children. Over 350 organizations united to help children and to support parents who'd like to but can't always be there. We know hundreds of ways, big and small, you too can make a difference. Reach us toll-free at 1-888-544-KIDS or online at www.kidscampaigns.org. We're fighting for the children. Whose side are you on?
A message from the Coalition for America's Children and the Ad Council.
We've had the words and music for the wedding march. All right, we've got some here. This is not available on any of his albums, but it should be. This is from Milton Crabapple, Sheriff Milton Crabapple, and this is called Christmas in Crabapple. Listen.
Of course, the night before Christmas, and all through the house, everything had done settled down, quiet as a church mouse. Except Ma, that is. And she was up brushing her teeth. Then she laid them up on the mantel, right next to the wreath. She said, "Move over." Then she climbed into bed with that cream on her face and that net on her head. So I just turned on the TV, and wrestling was on. I said, "I best call my brother. Hand me the phone." I said, "Ma, the kids are all nestled snug in their bed. While them visions of sugar plums dance through their heads, go fetch me them stockings by the chimney with care. And let's eat some of that hard candy. It's one of them big chocolate squares. Then we'll eat some Rolaids and rub on some Bengay. I don't feel much like a long winter's nap anyway." And that's when I heard it. Ma said, "What's the matter?" "There's a prowler in the house. I just heard a clatter." Well, I jumped out of bed and grabbed my shotgun and headed for the living room at might near a dead run. I must have tripped over something. The whole goddamn Christmas tree fell. Crashing down came the angel, the lights, and the bell. But when I came to, this fellow's just standing there. He was wearing a red coat and black boots and had long, snowy, white hair. Now, I weren't wearing my glasses, so my vision was bleary, but I could tell he had a big nose, as red as a cherry. Now, he weren't a young fella, but he was lively and quick, and in a strange sort of way, he resembled old Saint Nick. Then he shouted, and he whistled to someone outside. I said, "You best be quiet. Ma, tan your hide. Who's Dancer? Who's Vixen? Them girlfriends yours? Who all's out there?" And I threw back the shutters, and there on the porch stood a big mule deer buck hitched up to my wagon filled with the toys from my truck. I said, "What in tarnation is going on here?" Well, sir, that little fella jumped up on that deer, and they lit out like a wharf rat over the top of the wall. I hollered, "Come back here. Come back here. Come back here, y'all. You bring back them presents. It's a crime to steal." But onward they flew, out across the cornfield. I yelled out for Ma. Then I ran into the yard, but then you just barely could see them. You had to look hard. Of course, I didn't have my glasses. Couldn't see who it was. No, Ma, it weren't Santa Claus. Whoever it was yelling as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to y'all, and to y'all a good night."
Christmas in Crabapple. Sheriff Milton Crabapple. Let's go to Valdosta, Georgia, and talk to Frank. Frank, how you doing?
Hello.
You behaving yourself?
You are a blessing in disguise. You know that?
Oh, thank you, sir.
Yeah, I'm a trucker, and I listen to you all over the state of Georgia when I can pick you up.
Bless you.
And it is a myth, but yesterday you was talking about what kids did to entertain themselves.
Yeah.
And it got me to thinking back in my late 40s when we were little kids, when we wasn't swabbing my dad's homebrew, and we got to school one morning, my sister got a quart of it, and we all got sick. and the teacher sent us home, and we all got a beating. But one other thing, you know, when kids get out of school during the summertime, we'd go through the mountains of West Virginia up there in Fayette County.
Yeah.
And underneath some rocks, there'd be caves, and we'd explore them caves. And this one particular time, my sister, she was the biggest one of the bunch, and she got hung up about halfway under that thing. And that big rock was about, I reckon it covered dang near a full block. And we had to go around on the other side and go in from the other side and crawl down through that thing and push her back out backwards.
Well, how far was it to where she was?
I reckon we were back in there about 50 foot underneath that thing, not thinking nothing about no snakes.
No.
You know, we didn't worry about that thing back then.
Oh, no, they...
When we was anywhere, you know, from 9 to 12 years old,
yeah,
snakes was the furthest thing from my mind.
And I bet your mother told you every day of your life, y'all stay out of those caves.
Every day. And, you know, if we wasn't doing that, we were climbing up in top of the trees, about 5 or 6 of them, get up in top of the trees.
Yeah.
And guess who was holding the axe? And we would cut down them trees now and fall with them.
Oh, that...
Not thinking 1 minute about getting hurt.
Did you ever get a broken arm out of that?
No, sir, none of us. I remember one time I was swinging on a grapevine swing over a bunch of rocks, and I got about halfway toward the swing, and it broke. And I hit the ground, and I hurt my back. As a matter of fact, I'm wearing a scar right now on my back.
You know, the wonderfulness of all of this is the way God looks after the little children.
If he hadn't, I love we'd have been dead a long time ago.
I promise you. Where are you headed in that big truck today?
Well, right now, I just got back from Miami. I'm probably going to have to turn around and go back. And, like I was telling Denny, I'm going to try to call these people over here in Valdosta to see if they can get WVLV to hook y'all up over here.
All right, buddy, good.
But I'm listening to you over at the WMTM, I think it is, Moultrie.
All right, we love it. You keep...
And do y'all have a schedule of... your radio stations around the area?
Yeah, if you'll call back when you get a chance and give us an address, we'll get it to you.
We'll get it, Ludlow.
All right, buddy.
Enjoy your program. Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you.
All right, buddy.
Bye-bye.
All right.
Listen, I want you to visit Colonel Poole's Barbecue in East LJ, Georgia, and see the world-famous Pig Hill of Fame. Here he is, the wildest man I know anything about, the guy with his hand up. Hello, big boy.
Wildest man? What are you talking about?
You are the wildest man I've ever known.
I'm right in the middle of Hog Mountain today.
Are you now?
I'm hog wild, I guess you could say.
I would certainly say that.
Downtown. Is everything going good with you?
Going very well. Going very well.
Yeah, I'm having a good day myself. The thing about the elk, though, wasn't it an elk or a moose?
An elk.
Elk, that's what I was thinking. I used to have raised elk, you know. At an elk farm.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
An elk kennel.
And they wouldn't eat lasagna.
No.
So that's the reason they can't say it, or wouldn't say it, or whatever, because they don't like it. I bought a bunch of lasagna to feed to them, and they wouldn't touch it.
Well, maybe the man was right. That explains it. Funniest thing I ever heard.
They love burritos, though.
They can say burritos, too.
Yeah, they can eat them burritos, yeah. Too, man. Hotter the better. Well, I guess that's about all I know today.
Really? You called to tell us about your good old elk farm there, did you?
Well, it brought back a lot of good memories, you know.
Your days on the elk farm.
I didn't make any money doing it, but, you know, it was fun.
But you met a lot of nice elks.
Oh, yeah, a lot of nice people. You know, people that own elks are some of the nicest people in the world.
Yeah, a common bond.
You know,
they sang the three of them.
Go to those, what do you sound like a steeplechase? You know, you ride elk in the steeplechase.
Really?
Yeah, they had it over there at Shake Rag for a while.
Mm-hmm.
But not too many people knew about it.
Uh-huh. All right. You take care of yourself.
I hope you have a big four.
I'll see you.
Okay, be careful.
Take care. And I hope you have a big...
Last October, I believe it was, we were going to hold a tent service off at this college town. And we got there about dinner time on Saturday. And different ones of us thought that we ought to get us a mouthful to eat before that we set up the tent. And so we got off of the truck and followed this little bunch of people through this small little bitty patch of woods there. And we come up on a big sign. It says, get something to eat here. And I went up and got me two hot dogs and a big orange drink.
And before that I could take every mouthful of that food, this whole raft of people come up around me and got me to where I couldn't eat nothing, up like, and I dropped my big orange drink. I did. Well, friends, they commenced to move, and there wasn't so much that I could do but move with them. Well, we commenced to go through all kinds of doors and gates and I don't know what all, and I looked up over one of them, and it says North Gate. And we kept on going through there, and pretty soon we come up on a young boy. And he says, ticket, please. And I says, friend, I don't have a ticket. I don't even know where it is that I'm going. I did. Well, he says, come out as quick as you can. And I says, I'll do her. I'll turn right around the first chance I get. Well, we kept on moving through there, and pretty soon everybody got where it was that they was a-going. Because they parted, and I could see pretty good. I could. And what I seen was this whole raft of people a-setting on these two banks and looking at one another across this pretty little green cow pasture. Well, they was. And somebody had tucked and drawed white lines all over it and drove posties in it and I don't know what all. And I looked down there and I seen five or six convicts a-running up and down and a-blowing whistles. They was. And then I looked down there and I seen these pretty girls a-wearing these little bitty short dresses and a-dancing around. And so I sat down and thought I'd see what it was that was going to happen. I did. And about the time I got set down good, I looked down there and I seen 30 or 40 men come running out of one end of a great big outhouse down there. They did. And everybody where I was a-setting got up and hollered. And about that time, 30 or 40 come running out of the other end of that outhouse and the other bank full, they got up and hollered. And I asked this fellow that was besetting beside of me, I says, friend, what is it that they're hollering for? Well, he whopped me on the back and he says, buddy, have a drink. Well, I says, I believe I will have another big orange. And I got it and sat back down. And when I got down there again, I seen that them men had got in two little bitty bunches down there. They had rail close together. And they voted. They did. They voted and elected one man apiece. And them two men come out in the middle of that cow pasture and shook hands like they hadn't seen one another in a long time. And then a convict come over to where they was a-standing, and he took out a quarter, and they come into odd man right there. They did. Well, after a while, I seen what it was that there's odd man in for. It was that both bunches full of them men wanted this funny-looking little pumpkin to play with. They did, and I know, friends, that they couldn't eat it because they kicked it the whole evening and it never busted. But anyhow, what I was telling was that both bunches full wanted that thing, and one bunch got it, and it made the other bunch just as mad as they could be, and friends, I seen that evening the awfulest fight that I have ever seen in my life. I did. They would run at one another and kick one another and throw one another down and stomp on one another and grind their feet in one another and I don't know what all. And just as fast as one of them would get hurt, they'd tow him off and run another one. Well, they'd done that as long as I sat there. But pretty soon, this boy that had said, ticket, please, he come up to me and he says, friends, you're going to have to leave because it is that you don't have a ticket. And I says, well, all right. And I got up and left. And I don't know, friends, to this day what it was that there's a-doing down there, but I have studied about it. And I think that it's some kindly of a contest where they see which bunchful of them men can take that pumpkin and run from one end of that cow pasture to the other without either getting knocked down or stepping in something.
Classic bit from Andy Griffith. What it was fruitball. 1-800-577.
An elk joke.
The world's only elk joke, and you have it.
I have it.
That's remarkable.
It goes like this. There's these three guys out hunting, and they come up on this glen, and they're soaring overhead is an eagle, and this one guy starts to take bead on it, and the other guy that's with him, he pulls it down. He pulls his gun down and says, "Don't shoot that." And he said, "Why?" He says, "Well, I'm an eagle, and it would offend me." He says, "Well, okay, I can understand that." And they go on a little ways, and they come up on this moose. And another guy raises his gun up and starts to fire, and another guy pulls his gun down, says, "Don't shoot that. I'm a moose, and it would offend me if you shot a symbol of our lodge." And they come up on this little clearing where there's a beautiful little pond there, and the elk is so peacefully having a drink and enjoying life. And this third guy he pulls up his shotgun and lets fire. Kablooey! And the other two guys look at him in disbelief, and they say, "John, you're an elk. Why did you shoot that?" He says, "It weren't no elk." They said, "Sure it was." He says, "It couldn't have been an elk." They said, "Why?" "He was drinking water." I snorted.
Oh, I heard you snort.
I snorted in your phone.
I heard you snort. I heard you snort. My man, you have a great weekend. We're about out of time here.
We put the lid on it, didn't we?
Yeah, we wound her up until first thing Monday morning when Mr. Frymeyer graces us with his presence.
I can't hardly wait.
I know that you're absolutely a twitter.
I know it.
I'll talk to you.
Bye now.
Bye-bye. Frymeyer, Monday morning, gang, you be sure and be here. We'll be talking about home remedies and all things folksy on the Fun Seekers Radio Network. Between now and then, you do me a favor. Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Winder, Georgia. This is AM 1300 WIMO.
Here's the latest from ABC News. I'm Linda Moore. More gunfire and panic in the nation's capital last night. Police say a gunman using a high-powered rifle peppered a northwest neighborhood. An emergency medical crew raced to the scene. ABC's Lauren Rogers was with them. The EMS crew waited until police could get a handle on the situation.
This, by far, is the scariest kind of environment to be in because you really don't know where any of these people are that are running around with these guns. They could be any place.
Medic supervisor Captain Jerry Stack, the gunman gave up. No one was hurt. Many medics wear bulletproof vests. Not DC medic Edward Womack.
What for? They just aim for the head. You know? I take my chances and don't wear anything. They're just going to see the vest and going to aim for the head. You know, they just no respect out there for it.
A 2-year-old Philadelphia girl is reported in critical but stable condition today at a local hospital following a torturous day yesterday at the hands of her mother. Police say the 21-year-old woman tied up, gagged, blindfolded, stabbed, and threw the nude toddler over a fence. The woman's in custody. Suffering with the flu? It's not being called an epidemic, but hospitals in Massachusetts and Rhode Island are packed with flu patients. Dr. John Santoro of the Bay State Medical Center in Springfield, Massachusetts, says there are classic flu symptoms.
If you start running a fever, muscle aches, runny nose, cough, any of those should result in a call to your physician.
Three schools in Ohio, two in Licking County, and one in Brown County are closed today because so many students have the flu. In Licking County, Nursing Director Nancy Hanger tells residents,
it's too late to get the actual flu vaccine. In fact, once there's a major outbreak in an area, people rushing in to get a flu vaccine is not the answer because they probably have already been exposed to it.
Doctors say bed rest and plenty of fluids are the best treatment for the flu. Now this.
The life of a nutcracker is not all it's cracked up to be. Put a walnut in my mouth, pull my arm, woo-hoo, I crack a big drill. But this very weekend, JCPenney is throwing some excitement our way. In a nutshell, they're opening early Friday at 9 a.m. and Saturday at 8 a.m. You can take $10 off most purchases of $100 or more throughout the store.
And there are a few restrictions. See your store for details.
It's a sale and this Saturday, December 14th, so hurry to JCPenney. Because this is one sale you'd be nuts to miss. Nuts.
Another great place to use Visa.
Far from the coast of Trinidad, you can still hear steel drums, or any drum at all, in Ohio, home of Columbus Percussion. With a drum come in as many shapes and sizes as the drummers who play them. If you've got rhythm, they've got the beat. So whether you play for a record label or the high school band, pick up some sticks and put down your Visa card. Because Columbus Percussion's one of the 7 million places that will take Visa, but won't take any card from American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
In 2 hours, President Clinton plans to hold a formal White House news conference. More from ABC's Bill Greenwood in Washington.
There is every reason to believe the president will tell reporters he's asked Attorney General Janet Reno to stay on at the Justice Department. And he might have something to say about filling vacancies at the United Nations, the Commerce Department, Energy, and other cabinet departments.
Mr. Clinton has reportedly chosen Democratic activist Bill Daley of Chicago as Commerce Secretary and Congressman Bill Richardson as U.N. Ambassador. Boston Red Sox pitcher Roger Clemens is about to become the highest-paid pitcher in baseball. Clemens has cut a 3-year deal with the Toronto Blue Jays worth nearly $25 million with an option for a fourth year. Reaction from Sporting News Managing Editor Bob Hilly.
Other guys have come and gone, you know, the Jim Rices and people like that, who bordered on being that type of player, but nobody has done it like Roger has.
Clemens, a 34-year-old, 3-time Cy Young Award winner, has been with the Red Sox for his whole pitching career. I'm Linda Moore, ABC News.
From the Weather Channel, this is meteorologist Paul Emick. We'll see mostly sunny skies for today with highs in the upper 50s to the middle 60s. Clear skies for tonight, a great night in store. Lows in the low 30s to the upper 30s in some spots. Tomorrow we'll see lots of sunshine yet again. What a great day. Highs in the low to mid 60s. A little bit cooler on Sunday, but still very sunny. Just a couple of clouds. We'll call it partly cloudy for the most part Sunday. High temperatures right around 60 degrees. From the Weather Channel, this is meteorologist Paul Emick.
And current temperature at WIMO is 54 degrees on the outside at AM 1300 WIMO in Winder, Georgia. It's very nice out there. As a matter of fact, a few clouds floating around here and there, but it's a fairly nice little bit of a breeze. And 54 degrees current temperature, looking for a high possibly up to about the 60s today. That's the way the forecast looks. Anyway, it looks kind of nice out there, especially considering how late in December it already is. It's time for Paul Harvey News and Comment now. That's heard each Monday through Saturday, brought to you by the People's Bank. It takes years of sunlight and rain for a tree to grow. But more importantly, it takes a deep root system. And over the past 70 years, that is what the People's Bank has been developing in Barrow and surrounding counties. A helpful staff gives you personal attention. With financial problems, services that meet your needs, and convenient locations, and solid roots in the community. The People's Bank stands out among the others, 70 years of growing and never forgetting how important you are. because at the People's Bank, people are our business. The People's Bank, with branches in Winder, Auburn, and Statham. Member FDIC. Come in and visit the friendly folks at the People's Bank today.
Hello, Americans. This is Paul Harvey. Stand by for news. Arthur Cahill of Branson, Missouri, was 89 last July, and I tell you, Arthur has tried a lot of electric shavers since the first ones. He's tried Shake, and he tried Remington and Norelco. He's even tried the super-duper expensive ones, unable to resist those extravagant claims. He's gone back to blade razors from time to time also. But now he has discovered Wall, and you should hear Arthur's effusive praise. Wall tops them all, he says. And he's bought another Wall this Christmas for his son, Doug. Because the Wall Shaver, W-A-H-L, the Wall Shaver is not one of those expensive things, and the Wall alone of them all comes with three separate cutting screens. There's one just right for any face, for any beard. It's the only electric shaver you can give as a gift because one Wall fits all. Most Walmart stores have the Wall Shaver. For the store nearest you, telephone 1-800-48-SHAVE. 1-800 and then 48-SHAVE. Scripture states that man was created by God. Some scientists insist that men evolved from monkeys. What if they're both right? Berkeley researchers in Java report the first evidence that as recently as 27,000 years ago, an ape-like man was living. At the same time, an anatomically modern man was living. The White House first unofficially let it be known that the president was considering for Commerce Secretary Chicago's Bill Daley and for U.N. Ambassador New Mexico's Congressman Bill Richardson. And having heard no serious objections, those appointments become official today. Congressional Budget Office has upped its economic forecast. For next year, they now expect our economy will grow another 2.3%. Business inventories are up. Unsold stuff on hand increased last month at the fastest rate in 9 months, but this will help. Holiday shoppers are skimming cream, buying up the pricey stuff from Neiman's and Saks and Tiffany. Neiman in Los Angeles offered 50 limited edition Jaguars for $75,000 each, sold all 50 in 8 days. Saks in New York has sold most all of its cashmere. Shoplifter in Troy, Michigan, got out of the Nordstrom store, but had a hard time getting into her getaway car with a full-length fur coat stuffed inside her pants. The Wall Street roller coaster was down almost 100 points yesterday. Overnight in Tokyo, Japanese investors took profits also. The Nikkei average nosedived 2.5%. But then, the bargain hunters moved into the Tokyo market, and it closed down less than 1%. Bargain hunters were buying this morning on Wall Street also. A 5% correction might be more helpful than hurtful, except, of course, for the jumpers. In Tacoma, Washington, Doris Willis went to the bank Wednesday to leave some things in her safe deposit box. Inadvertently, the bank vault was closed. Nobody noticed that she was still inside. And she remained inside in pitch dark the rest of the day and all of the night, until finally the vault was opened yesterday morning. Doris Willis, 87, was safe in the safe. She says while she was in there, she prayed in the dark and felt around for some kind of an alarm button, and she found one that alerted police, but they came to the bank and left without examining the vault. The bank promises to do something nice for her. I should think so. A young woman for all seasons, Mona Knock, K-N-O-C-K, of Chicago, licensed to fly airplanes, a marathon runner, a chemistry major at the University of Chicago with a scholarship waiting at Oxford, and she is a world-class violinist. And Mona Knock is not yet 21. Page 2, the holiday season is here, and you know what that means. Shopping and cooking, eating and partying, and more eating. With so many things going on, so many tempting holiday treats around. This is the easiest time of the year to let your health habits slide. Well, let them slide a smidgen if you want. But this holiday season, let's remember that breakfast is a good time to turn things around. And at breakfast time, let's have a bowl of Total. Because one bowl of Total, Total Raisin Bran or Total Corn Flakes, one bowl gives you 100% of 10 of the many vitamins and minerals that you need every day, especially during the busy holiday season. And Total is low in fat. That's a good thing. You know you're going to have an extra helping of stuffing, so you'll want something low in fat for breakfast. So this season, between all of the shopping and the partying and all of the overindulging, let's start the day with Total. One bowl. 100%. We have some unfinished business. Offshore New York, after TWA Flight 800 exploded, there were reports of sightings of what appeared to be fiery missiles in flight that night. Now, those were dismissed as possible meteorites. Well, now, the crew of a Saudi jetliner reports similar sightings, except this is a green flare high in the air near there and yesterday. This green flare light, the FBI is again dismissing as most likely a meteor shower. Little more unfinished business. Yesterday, you and I talked about the Pensacola University shopping mall, which had evicted Christmas carolers. That mall's management has changed its mind. Carolers, welcome. To whom it may concern, December 1 year ago, you were grocery shopping at the Aldi store in Centralia, Illinois. You are a pretty woman, middle 30s. That day you were wearing a dark blue cloth coat. Ahead of you in the checkout line, another woman, a stranger to you, did not have enough cash for her grocery purchase, and the store did not accept checks. So the embarrassed shopper chose to set aside the cream cheese that she had intended to purchase. She paid for the other things, $8, but left the 5 packages of cream cheese. At that moment, you, whoever you are, quietly asked the cashier if you might pay for the cream cheese yourself. And you did. And you passed on through the checkout line, and you caught up with the stranger leaving the store and presented her with the cheese. She said, "You do not need to do that. I have other money at home. I can afford to buy the cheese, really." But you insisted, and you smiled, and you said Merry Christmas, and neither of you ever saw the other again. Well, ma'am, whoever you are, if you remember that day, you might want to know that the woman to whom you presented 5 packages of cream cheese a year ago was Betty Lockhart of Centralia. 6 children and 8 great-grandchildren, a life member of her husband's 2nd Marine Division Association. The day you met her last Christmas, she knew it would be her last Christmas. With cancer even then stealing her away from us, she was very tired, very sick, feeling very low. But after your generous gesture, she was so encouraged, so uplifted, that she had more than enough energy to prepare a happy Christmas dinner for her arriving family. Betty Lockhart died last July of 69, but she never stopped telling us about you, about the beautiful lady in the blue coat whose niceness had dissolved her fears and quieted her anxious heart and had brightened the rest of her life. Page 3.
It's time to play What a Dope, the show where kids who smoke marijuana try to answer incredibly simple questions. Okay, for $100, what did you eat for breakfast, Brian?
I forget most.
That's Brian. Let's move on. For $500, what is your first name? Debbie.
Brian.
Sorry, Debbie. The answer is Debbie, your own first name.
Really?
That's okay. Just try and concentrate for 2 or 3 seconds, okay?
Okay.
Okay. For $1,000, what day comes after Sunday? Brian.
French toast.
That's incorrect, Brian. And guess what?
Give me a hit, man.
You lose. Wow, it's right because marijuana has made you a complete imbecile.
I don't want to be that.
Hey, tune in again tomorrow and remember, if you smoke marijuana, you're
on.
Brought to you by the Partnership for a Drug-Free America.
Yes, my treasured friend, I do know that this is Friday the 13th, but intelligent people ignore superstition. Today is just another day, as long as you don't whistle indoors. Ski bombs lace up and clamp down. Steamboat has 5 inches of new powder on a 53-inch base. At the second O.J. Simpson trial, like the first, the strategy for the defense is to try to prove the police did it. Your Parade magazine this weekend is going to include a poll of 55,000 readers in which an overwhelming majority, 81%, believe that the United States system of justice really needs to be reformed. A medical helicopter in upstate New York picked up an injured hunter. He'd fallen out of a tree, but flying him toward the hospital, the copter crashed, killing all three aboard. New Yorkers are going to pay a price for rudeness. Many have been boarding city subways and taking 2 seats, putting their backpacks on the seat alongside. Some of them park coffee on the seat alongside, while other passengers are forced to ride standing. But from now on, 1 seat per 1 passenger or a $50 fine. Former President Reagan's only brother, John Neil Reagan, has died in Rancho Santa Fe at 88. He directed Ronnie during Death Valley days. This year's flu bug is a tough one. My goodness, it shut down some schools in Ohio after more than a fourth of the students got it. You do know that a misprinted postage stamp is particularly valuable to collectors because of its rarity. Some Richard Nixon stamps were printed with his name upside down. Suddenly, that 32-cent stamp is worth thousands. In fact, a collection of them sold at Christie's auction for $800,000. And now postal inspectors say that the seller who profited had been a worker at the plant where the stamps were printed. It's the first instance, so far as I know, of insider trading in stamps. If, in fact, he stole the stamps, Clarence Roby could go to prison for 20 years. The state of Virginia killed a killer this morning. This one had been on death row at your expense for 13 years. Since long before that, he wore a tattoo on his arm which said, "Born to Die." Redding, California is talking about John Sickman. When a robber intruded on the Sickman house at midnight and demanded money, when the robber told the family to cough up some cash and they said there was no cash in the house, the robber began beating Mrs. Susan Sickman. And that's when John got a baseball bat and lit into the robber and banged him up enough so that police had only to look for the guy with the bruises. No, Mr. Sickman was not home. He was away at work. Gutsy John Sickman is there.